As you put the idea of the Dalek together, you also allowed for the fact that there would be a mutant person inside, although we never saw them,
never saw the Dalek. It was, as I've often said, it was editorial policy not to show the Dalek, because it was too horrible. It was a horrible mutant. And also to suggest horror, so that it's this wonderful extra dimension of the audience. If you just suggest horror, they will fill in the gaps. And it would be far more horrible than anything you could design.
Well, of course, the Dalek was pretty horrible, but it was put together with just sort of bits and bobs, really. It wasn't some fantastic space-age job, was it?
No, it was done on a very, very small budget. Very small budget. There were four made, just for a matter of a few hundred pounds.
And what was it, hardboard with a plunger?
Fiberglass. It was, one was, a mould was made, and four were cast off in fiberglass.
Well, they... Was it really a sink plunger that they used?
It was. Originally, it was going to be nippers, like claws, but we couldn't afford that. So we came up with this idea with a plunger.
Well, it worked. It worked very well indeed. Over now to Debs.
Good job. It wasn't nippers. A sink plunger was bad enough for me. Just how far the Daleks have infected public awareness is illustrated by our next item. You just wait for this. Just about everyone in the country knows them and their threatening tones. So we went out into the streets armed only with a sink plunger, and this is what happened. Now, part of the appeal of Doctor Who is the number of monsters encountered by the good Doctor and his companions on their adventures. We're all familiar with the Daleks, but just how keen are you on the others? In a recent poll of Doctor Who fans, these are the ones that came out top in a monster top 10. Plungers were actually down here. Why did they, everyone put them up to their heads earlier on? Now, as we're coming close to the end of our Doctor Who weekend, it's time to return to hear some more thoughts from the series' first producer, Verity Lambert. When I went to see her in her West London office, she talked about those ever-popular Daleks and discussed something dear to the hearts of all of you fans out there, the future for Doctor Who.
They are approaching.
First time I went down to rehearsal and we had them there, and you know, people were practicing in them, everybody wanted to get inside one. All the actors, me, everyone. So I knew immediately that somehow we'd got it right.
Not much room for my legs, but try the top.
We did a Dalek serial where they invaded Earth, and there was a wonderful thing where we were allowed to film on a Sunday, with the Daleks outside the House of Parliament. And that was actually quite marvellous, sort of seeing them coming over the bridge, you know, towards the House of Parliament.
Did it change very much after you left?
Perhaps it's become a bit of a parody in the last few years. It doesn't take itself as seriously. And in a way, I think that's a pity, because I think good stories always work. And I suppose if I was... I regret the fact that Doctor Who's become a bit of a joke.
Are you still happy to be associated with Doctor Who?
Well, I am certainly happy to have been associated with it, absolutely. It's one of the things I've enjoyed most doing. One of the things I look back on with great affection.
Would you ever like to be involved again?
Well, I'd sort of like to have a go at doing it all on film and see what happened then.
Is that a likelihood?
I don't think so.
Now, the Daleks were originally created by Terry Nation. Their chilling cruelty, their robot technology ensured them lasting popularity. Terry Nation, now a Hollywood writer and producer, and the early production team, had no idea the Daleks would become one of the landmark creations of science fiction. Our Los Angeles producer caught up with them.
I had grown up in the cinema, at the front row of the Odeon all my life, practically. And I used to love the, what were then, rated H pictures, horror films. And there was The Mummy and The Frankenstein Monster and all of those things. And even though I thought they were wonderful, I always knew that the monster was a man dressed up. And so when I came to make my own monster, I wanted to make sure that it was not a man dressed up. Now, the only thing you can do with that, I think, is to take the legs off.
You have destroyed our videoscope and one of our limbs.
And you in turn killed the Thal leader in your ambush. You will be responsible for more deaths unless you help these people.
The only interest we have in the Thals is their total extermination.
When I wrote that first block of Dalek episodes, I worked on the assumption that this was take the money and fly like a thief. The show cannot last beyond its original 13. I mean, what a dumb show, I said. And so I killed them off, knowing that there would be no future for these guys. Then I figured, we had to get them back, and I felt a bit like Conan Doyle trying to get Sherlock Holmes back from the Reichenbach Falls. But then it occurred to me that we were moving through time, so what we could have what we saw was the ultimate end of the Daleks, and now we could go back and see other things that they had done in time, which justified it for me, and I think everybody else, but we finally didn't care too much, you know. I think they were bad. They weren't grey, they weren't nice bits about them, they were bad guys. And I think everybody could relate to that. Doctor Who and the Daleks probably helped science fiction enormously. I mean, science fiction was a dirty word, it was sub-literature at that time. It has introduced kids, to good science fiction, who then went on to read the great writers of science fiction. It's now, certainly science fiction is a bigger part of our culture than it ever was when we came on the air. So I think it's very valid to say we did make a contribution.
Our prisoners are intelligent and perhaps dangerous. Why not exterminate them?
I have a great pride in the fact that the word is in the dictionary, that I created these creatures, that they still exist. And I suppose everything surprises me, but now it's that they've been a part of my life for so long that I can't think of my career without them.
Well, stay with us now for the second Doctor Who feature film starring Peter Cushing as the Doctor. This film was based on the TV story The Dalek Invasion of Earth and produced by Amicus Films. Roberta Tovey appears again, and Bernard Cribbins plays a British policeman who joins the TARDIS crew. Join us after the break for Daleks Invasion Earth 2150 AD.